Dear students, now we are going to discuss about coefficient of restitution. About coefficient of restitution, we can say when two bodies collide, then this is a constant parameter. Which accounts for the elasticity of material of bodies which are colliding, and it is mathematically defined as this coefficient of restitution is denoted by the letter alphabet E, which is written as velocity of separation along line of impact divided by velocity of approach along line of impact. So, this we can say that it is a ratio of separation velocity to approach velocity along line of impact. Say when two bodies collide, then approach velocity is there before the collision and separation velocity is there after the collision. Like for a simple example, say if a body is moving towards the other body and say the bodies are moving with the speeds u1 and u2 such that u1 is more than u2 because of which the bodies are colliding. So we can say if the two bodies will collide and after collision if the bodies will get separated. So, here we can state in this situation after separation if the velocities are v1 and v2 for the two bodies such that v2 is more than v1. So, in this situation here approach velocity for the two bodies we can write as relative velocity before collision, that will be v approach is equals to u1 minus u2. Similarly, velocity of separation is the relative velocity of the body 2 with respect to body 1 after collision. So, here separation velocity v separation can be written as v2 minus v1. So, in this particular collision if we define this coefficient of restitution, then the value of E can be written as v2 minus v1 upon u1 minus u2. This is the way how mathematically this coefficient of restitution is defined for a given situation. And this coefficient of restitution, its numerical value depends actually on the type of material of bodies which are colliding. Here for different type of bodies, we can write for different type of material, of bodies, numerical value of E, the coefficient of restitution is different. Here we can say for bodies involved in elastic collision when we talk about. For elastic collision it is observed that the value of coefficient of restitution is 1. Similarly for partial elastic collisions. The value of E is less than 1, which is more than 0 also we can state. And when we talk about inelastic collisions, where we already studied that in case of inelastic collisions, no separation takes place between bodies after collision along line of impact. So, coefficient of restitution is 0. This directly implies as it is velocity of separation upon velocity of approach. We can state if coefficient of restitution is 0, the velocity of separation will be 0. This implies bodies do not separate along line of impact. In various numerical problems, we are going to use the value of E as a very important tool for analyzing problems. We'll see several problems based on the numerical value of E soon. Let's see different type of collisions. As just now we have discussed about coefficient of restitution, so we can say based on material of bodies involved in collision, these are categorized in three ways, which we have just now discussed on the previous slide. Number one is elastic collision. For elastic collisions, we can state when bodies are elastic, during collision, whatever deformation exists, or you can say during collision, whatever potential energy is stored in deformation of bodies will be fully recovered in form of kinetic energy. So we can state in such cases, that is in case of elastic collisions, before and after collision, no energy loss takes place in deformation of bodies. So, in most of the cases, we can write initial kinetic energy before collision is equals to final kinetic energy after collision for the bodies if no other kind of dissipation is taking place. Similarly, we can define partially elastic collision. So, in elastic collision, we already studied the coefficient of restitution is always taken as 1. Similarly, we can define partially elastic collisions as we know, in case of partially elastic bodies, whatever deformation takes place, it is not fully recovered in any other form because some amount of energy is lost against lattice friction at the time of deformation. So, we can say in case of partial elastic collision, we can write in such cases, some energy loss takes place during collision under deformation of bodies. So, in such cases, we can write initial kinetic energy of bodies before collision is always greater than final kinetic energy of bodies after collision. And for this, we have studied the value of coefficient of restitution is less than 1 and more than 0. Now, the last type of collision based on type of materials used in bodies is inelastic collision. As we have studied that in case of inelastic bodies, whatever work is done in deformation will be lost against lattice friction and no energy is left over for recovery. And no restoring force is generated in case of inelastic body. So, we can say in inelastic collision, we can write in such cases, loss in energy during collision will be maximum and after collision no restoring force exists for separation of bodies. due to which we have studied that the numerical value of coefficient of restitution for inelastic collision is 0. So these are three different type of collisions which are categorized based on different type of material of bodies. Similarly, we can classify collision based on direction of motion of bodies before and after collision. So we can write classification of collisions based on motion direction. In this classification, we'll see that all type of collisions are basically classified in two categories. There are generally two categories which exist for directional classification. The very first is head-on collisions, and number two is oblique collisions. Head-on collisions are also generally termed as one-dimensional collisions, and oblique collisions are 2D or 3D collisions. In head-on collisions, when bodies are moving, they move before collision along the same line, so that after collision also they'll move along the same line. Such type of collisions we have just now studied are generally termed as head-on collisions. Oblique collisions are the cases when bodies are moving with some offset in their velocity directions, like one body is moving here, other is moving here, and if the two bodies are striking after collision, one body goes here, other body goes here. So initial direction you can state one body is moving with the speed u1, second body is moving with the speed u2. After collision, first body is going with the speed v1 and second body is going with the speed v2. In such cases, we can state if direction of motion of the two bodies before collision are different, then after collision certainly their directions will again be different. Such type of collisions we term as oblique collisions. Now we'll study head-on and oblique collisions one by one in detail from the next article.